Invercargill is one of the most southernmost cities of the world, next stop being Antarctica. The two-hour drive was not without its moments. We got lost, I really had to use the bathroom, and we got a speeding ticket. And we got lost because we used Google Maps. And so if you want to get directions from them and get a nice tour of Wallacetown, go ahead and do so. But what I suggest is follow the signs to Invercargill. And when you see the McDonald's, turn left on Gala Street. The legendary Burt Munro re-engineered a 1920 Indian Scout motorbike, the Munro Special Indian, to break records throughout New Zealand and the USA from the 1920s to the mid-1970s. The Indian was capable of 55 to 60 miles per hour and re-engineered to break records at speeds approaching 200 miles per hour. He was still racing and breaking records at the age of 77. This motorcycle is one of two working replicas built by the Britain Motorcycle Company for the movie, The World's Fastest Indian. It shows the 1920 Indian Scout as it would have looked during Burt's record attempt at Bonneville in 1962. During his lifetime, Burt made the journey 14 times to Bonneville Speed Week at the Utah Salt Flats between 1962 and 1977. To test out his latest mechanical developments on his bike and have its speed professionally recorded. He would then return to Southland, New Zealand and work up to 18 hours a day to tune, rebuild, re-engineer his bike before returning to Utah for speed timing. He made his own lubrication system, pistons, flywheels, cylinder barrels, conrods, cams, and followers. The idea for the design of the shell came from watching the incredible speeds of goldfish at Invercargill's Queen's Park ponds.